Initially, it was very tough because he's an Indian cooking a traditionally Chinese dish. So we get many reactions from customers that ask, do you know what you're doing?
Do you know what is bak chor? At the end of the day, we let the food do the talking.
When the food is good, it's just, it doesn't matter from what race. If it's good, people will just continue to come in and just that kind of actually encourage us to go on.
We came to the decision to cook food outside of ethnicity because we both enjoy having curry over like meals, so by pure coincidence.
It's like a potluck party where my friend cooked with biryani rice and then I roasted a whole slab of pork. And then we tasted it like roasted pork with biryani and curry. It's pretty good together. So that's how it came about. I think it's more to the background. If you go to any biryani store or curry places, it's usually mutton or chicken or fish or prawn probably. So we thought, what if we change or try to do something with a different taste profile?
So we are on a quest to find the flavor by learning from the spice uncle at Cantonese and then learning from Indian neighbors.
It's more of like balancing what we know, what we have like learned from Indian culture and sort of like merge it with what we have and putting it out there as a reinvented Chinese cuisine.
We would say we are more like a deconstructed biryani, taking parts out and then try to put them back together to create like a different profile.
I've been supporting Mr. and Mrs. Tan as a customer for about 18 years. So one day, Mrs. Tan just asked somebody wants to take over because I guess her children do not want to do it. So we took it upon ourselves to commit. Mr. Tan, he learned from his Malay neighbors who guided him, taught him, and we learned from it. But we did improvise a little bit.
Yeah, we enhanced the flavor a bit. So we fried the rumbao, all this kind of enhanced the flavor more, the aroma.
Fishball noodles and bak chor mee. It was actually our childhood favourite, so we decided on these two dishes. We are very particular about all the different elements that come into our dish.
The minute is a little bit soggy, you know, the whole dish is off. And I think that's as basic as it gets, no fancy ingredients, just a simple staple that, you know, hopefully everybody enjoys. In trying to keep it as simple as possible, that translates to it being authentic, hopefully, as well.
Getting feedback from Indian ethnicity is the highest accomplishment that we have. When they told us it's of like their mom's cooking and to keep up the good job, they were like, bring more friends to come and support us. It's like, it's pretty well received lah.
Initially, it was very tough. He's an Indian cooking a traditionally Chinese dish. Some ran away, some hid behind walls, some didn't have very nice things to say. In the end, you just try not to let it affect you. And
many of those who doubted us from the start were succumbed to curiosity. And once they tried it, they just kept coming back.
I think it's the tradition to preserve the nasi padang, the traditional taste of the barbecue, all this. These are the things that motivate us to give people the same taste as what they had tried before.
I think it really motivates us when, while they're working, you just see them, you know, like
Wiping their nose,
just like, you know, going all full on to the bowl and they just give you one like thumbs up and, you know, you see them return again. You know, that's what keeps us going every day.